bribe kids with candy. It always works. It's a pretty Sunday, it's sunny today, so yeah, I'm just gonna go on a huge Sunday walk, and I genuinely, like, I have no plans. I'm just gonna see where the day takes me. Walking on the street, and I just saw this little boy, and he fell when he was riding his scooter, like, face first into the ground, and he starts crying. And this bag, I take this bag everywhere, like, I always carry it, and it's full of candy, because basically, like, I bribe my little cousins and I always keep candy in my bag, and I always carry, like, the same handbag because I can't be bothered, like, you know, always putting my stuff from one bag to another. And when I saw him fall, I just, like, pulled out a lollipop, and I was like, yeah, do you want this? And he instantly just stopped crying. The kid was literally hysterical. He went from hysterical to smiling real quick. So yeah, I'm on to something. Bribery. I've been walking for like 45 minutes, and I was like, I just need to sit down. I just stopped for a little coffee break. I have crazy, like, neck and shoulder pain. When I landed in London, I basically went for a massage, and then the lady, she, like, found a lump in the back of my neck, and it was like this big. And it was low-key concerning, but then, you know, I went to dinner with one of my friends, and basically, like, he has access to a lot of money, meaning he has access to, like, the best healthcare and this and that. So I was like, oh my gosh, you know, I need to get this checked out, it could be anything. And then literally he was like, just breathe. And I was like, what? And I just felt so dramatic and stupid, because I was like, yeah, this guy's completely right. When you're stressed out, when you're anxious, when you're not breathing, like, that's when you get the neck and shoulder pain. He told me that he used to always complain about it too, and that's, you know, the advice that his physio or whatever gave him. Because I guess when you're not, like, breathing properly, like, this bit around your neck and shoulders, it's like tense, and it just tenses up. So yeah, I can't really complain about it because I'm doing it to myself. So I just need to chill out. So I was just shopping across the road in Knightsbridge, and Harrods is across the road there, and then here's Hyde Park, and I just saw all of this going on. Maybe because the Queen's passed away, I guess. So I just bought myself some scent for my hair. I'm so happy. I bought myself this hair scent from this store up the road that does really beautiful fragrances, and they make all their fragrances in Paris. One thing about me is that I always like to have my hair smelling really, really good, because brown girl things, but obviously me living in my ethnic household, every time there's food being made in the house, that the scent of the food, it really catches in my hair and my clothing. So Yeah, I definitely needed to go and get that. So now I'm way more mature when I shop, for sure, and I only buy things from brands that actually like specialize in what they're making. So like if I'm gonna buy fragrance, it's gonna be from, you know, a company that only makes fragrances and specializes in fragrances. Or like if I want a bag, I'm gonna go to Bottega and get it because, you know, that's their thing, bags. Or if I want a coat, then I'm gonna go to Burberry and get it because that's what they specialize in. That's their thing. Like, there's really no point falling for marketing and buying cheap quality things from these brands. Like, there's no point falling for the marketing of it and, like, you know, buying cheap quality things for so much. It's just a waste of money. And yeah, one thing about me is that I don't fall for the marketing. I don't care about the brand. I don't care about the brand name. I just stopped for a quick salad. That street is really busy. That's why I've just come to the park, because I just needed space and I just needed to like step back for like a few minutes and just chill out. It's crazy like what stress can do to your body. It's the worst thing for your health, and I've seen it firsthand in the past couple of weeks. Literally, like, I felt like I've had these knots in my stomach just from being anxious, and these twisted and turning, like, the feeling, I can't even explain it, but it's just, it's so brutal. So like when you're in a big city, your problems just feel so little, your day just goes by so fast, and you're just, there's so many people around you all the time, and you know, like nothing feels like a big issue. Whereas when you're in a little small town, time kind of moves a bit slower, and you really just kind of have the time to overthink. But like here, life just moves so quickly that I don't really have like too much time to think. It's 8 o'clock and I'm almost home. It's been a huge day of walking. I don't know if it's like an Uber Eats and chill kind of night, or if I should go out. What should I do? I don't know. I'm just like laying on the couch and I'm looking at all the random bruises on my legs, and I'm like, where does this come from? Like, what were you doing? They're like purple and gray bruises, and like I have no idea where they come from. It's when I go out at night. Like every time I go out, I wake up with all these bruises. But to be fair, I have really bad eyesight, so every morning when I'm getting ready, I like bump into the couch, and I'm always like running into walls and stuff. Like, I'm back to my extremely messy apartment. Please don't judge me, but yeah, I think I'm gonna be a responsible child and clean this mess up, because I've got a flight in 2 days. And yeah, like half of me is like, oh my god, the place is so fun, let's go, and then the other half is kind of like, been there, done that, who cares. And yeah, I don't know. I think I'm gonna be a responsible child. I'm gonna clean that mess up. I'm gonna pack my suitcase because I've got a flight in 2 days, and then it's Uber Eats and have a bath kind of night. Good morning. So it's my last day in London, and basically all morning I was just like running around. Yeah, tomorrow I'm off to India. I'm off to Mumbai. First things first, it's like 26 degrees, so I need to get a coffee. My apartment is actually really close to Harrods, so it's literally like walking distance, so it's really convenient for me to just like go there. So I've just come to the Jimmy Choo cafe. literally feel like a little princess just sitting like in my balcony and yeah, enjoying my morning coffee. This cafe is so cute. So all morning I've literally just been running around, and finally like I'm done running errands, and I had a bit of issues with my visa and I have a flight tomorrow, so I spent the morning sorting all of that out, and now I'm just free for the day. But yeah, I was trying to plan my day and kind of like think, what do I want to do today? Because low-key I've kind of done like all the touristy things in London already, so the only two things that I kind of have left to do here, one is the Tower of London, and like people have died there, so I just don't want to go there because I don't think the energy there is going to be good. And then I guess the other touristy thing that I haven't done here is gone to the Warner Brothers studio. But like the thing about that is that I'm not, my cousin is, she loves Harry Potter, but like I don't know, I'm just not like the biggest Harry Potter fan, so I feel like it's not going to be that fun for me. In the evening I'm meeting my friends from New Zealand for dinner, and I'm meeting them in an area called Hampstead, and I've actually never been there before. I think after I finish my coffee I'm just gonna head there and enjoy my last day in London, do the things that she told me to do, and then yeah, meet my friends for dinner, my last little day in London. So I've left Harrods now and I'm just going to Kenwood House because I've got to see my friends from New Zealand for dinner in that area. So I honestly just needed to leave Harrods, because when you come out of the cafe, the baby section's there, like, and it's all the kids' children designer clothing, and it's so cute. Like they've got little like prams, like Dior prams, and like the school bags, and it was actually like, it was giving me baby fever being there and like seeing it all. Well, not me, okay, not me, but like I need my brother or one of my friends, or I need someone to have a baby so I can like dress it up and play with it. I don't even want a husband, I just want the children. Like I don't care about the husband, but I really want the kids. So there's been a change of plans. I'm not going to Kenwood House because it's closed, and I was like, there's no point in me going there if I can't go inside. And the whole reason why I wanted to even go inside is because Dido Bell lived there, and there's a photograph in there which is, I think it's a replica of this painting, and she's in it, and I really wanted to see that. So you know, and she's painted, she's actually half black, but she's painted equally to a white female. Dido was actually the illegitimate child of a young black woman. Slavery was legal then, and her father was a Royal Naval officer, and the fact that she was brought up in that house as a family member, that's very uncommon because she was like an illegitimate mixed race child. So Dido's great uncle was Lord Mansfield, who was like this powerful judge, and he actually he let an escaped slave go free and didn't sentence them to death. And at that time, like that's something that would not happen. So you know, she probably did influence some of his decisions. So Dido Bell is thought to be like the first black aristocrat. She's iconic for like a lot of reasons, so if you don't know about her, definitely go research about her. To be honest, I don't know where I'm going. I just kind of put this place into Uber and showed up here, and I didn't even know like what to expect. Like I swear I didn't even look at Google photos or anything. I genuinely just showed up, and it's such a cute place. It's like after weeks and weeks of being in central London and like having such a fast-paced life where everything is so loud, after weeks there's like some peace and quiet. I shouldn't get too comfortable with this because
tomorrow I'm flying to India. And it's definitely not quite like this there. This is the kind of house that I would want to like raise kids in. A house with a big, 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 big garden. I seriously love places like this. I swear, like, my one thing in life is that I want a white house with pillars, and I want a beautiful garden, like secret garden vibes, like this, like the olden days. I genuinely want my future house to have like a very, I don't know, like royal kind of aesthetic to it. Like this thingy, we love this. If I can hear my voice echoing, then I'm happy. Like this. I want my future house to have this kind of thing. I see some white pillars, even though they're not that white anymore, but we're just gonna pretend. You go, this is exactly what I mean. Like balconies. Don't ask me how much this dream home is going to cost, because I haven't thought about the funds yet, but this place is actually so cute. I feel like I'm a little princess walking around my castle, like from the olden days, just wandering around. So easy to spot. Do we know this girl? Hi. Hello, so I am back from dinner. I need to drink water. I feel like I haven't drank water for like 6 weeks. I kid you not. I used to drink like 3 liters of water without fail every day. And like for the past couple of weeks, I haven't been drinking water, so I feel not nice, not good. If you want to lose weight, honestly, you don't have to do anything. You don't have to like eat clean. You don't have to exercise. Obviously, don't eat like 5 pizzas. But you can eat like 1 slice of pizza. But literally just drink a lot of water. Like drink so much water like you never have in your life. Drink liters and liters. Just drink a lot of water. And slowly but surely, like you'll lose weight. Like your body will shape up. So I went to dinner with my friends. These are like my real friends, you know. So I didn't like pick up the camera and vlog because it would have just been like super inappropriate, because like they check in with me and I check in on them, and it's like it would have been super inappropriate to just like start vlogging when people are telling me like, you know, about their life. So now I'm leaving London and I'm off to India. You fade away, yeah, yeah.